physics from IIT Kanpur in 1977. Followed it, he joined the PhD program at the institute and completed same in less than 3 years despite being motivated by his teachers to move to Europe, US for higher studies. He chose to go back to his native place and joined Patna Science College as a lecturer in 1980. He served there for 15 years. He joined the Department of Physics at IIT Kanpur as assistant professor in 1994. Of course, his interest wide from classical and quantum mechanics and nuclear physics. But he chose to write a lot of books. And among them, there was a quantum phase was one of the popular books which I written. But more importantly, he's known to people as when they started giving a lot of video lectures, you know, a lot of basic how to teach physics. And you know, recently, he's very active as a digital videos also, a MOOC, and a number of participants. I don't know, somebody was telling is it's more than 10,000, 15,000, I don't know what's the number. But it's immensely popular. Yes, indeed. And one of the speakers talked about his you know, kind of royalty of the book, you know, which, essentially he contributes everything to the success of one. And that's where it becomes an important activity in his life. As a public activity, he has been very active, I think, from earliest days. And as a socialist, also he's very well known. He's co-founded various social activities or initiatives. And one of them is physicist, which of course we have also visited, which literally means a ladder for education and for the growth and upliftment of underprivileged kids in and around IIT campus. You know, I can keep talking about it. Rather, me talking, I would like Professor Verma to come on the stage and, you know, have a mutually kind of interaction. So with that, I invite Professor Verma to come.
For such a nice introduction, and thank you IIT Kanpur to give me this opportunity to talk to so many people, nice people at one go. It's a very different kind of audience that I am facing. Never this kind of creative audience in one go. I'm really thankful to the organizers. And this particular topic that was suggested by the organizers, because I used to work with village people and others, so perhaps they decided to give me this topic. And I am very happy because I didn't have to prepare anything for this. Normally, whenever there is a talk, one has to prepare. But for me, it was alright. So the basic thing is that how higher education institutes can contribute for that. That's the basic thing that I have picked up. And IIT Kanpur has really set an example. The kind of sensitivity IIT Kanpur has shown to this nuclear prevalence inspection, the kind of thing that they have provided, and because of which we could do so much of things, so that will be the main theme of this talk. Alright, so the great Indian tradition is there from Takshashila University, Nalanda University to the modern institutes of learnings. And and this is a famous writing from Mahatma Gandhi's second Goldsmiths conference, where he stated that in India before the British came, the education was available to all. Now we are talking of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan and this and that, but that Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan was there. And then he says that the village schools were not good enough for the British administrators. So he came out with this program. Every school must have so much of paraphernalia, building, and so forth and so forth. And from there the things started declining. And a section, underprivileged section, came up. Before that, education was available to everyone. And somehow we are following the same Sanskarik Shikshan Kendra. You must have seen. We cannot call it a school, otherwise we will be behind the bars. So if people are there, they want to impart education. They cannot, because they do not have that 2 acres of land and those many halls of that particular size and this and that. All that which was imposed by Britishers, which made a large sections which could not, they did not have access to the good institutions, good academic activities. That's the tragic part of it. Okay? But even with that kind of system, where a large number of our population is not having access to higher education or good quality education, we are still reasonably good in the world scenario. No? We do have lots of technical achievements and we have something to do. Is it because we are a large population? Our strength lies in huge population. So whatever you do, if the total sample size is so big, then a number, a required number which can sustain the activity in country will still be there. So is it because of the system that we are achieving those technical technology advancement, or it's because of that huge population number that we have, that even if we ignore 90%, 95%, even then there is a critical mass which can sustain the activities? So that is the question. Alright, now I'll give 2-3 activities which IIT Kanpur had supported for this undergraduate underprivileged section. And the first I want to take it is this opportunity school. Now this opportunity school was started almost 3-4 years after this institution, this IIT was established. And it was thought by some senior faculty members, housewives at that time, late 1960s, this institute started. 60s, Mr. Ram Chandran and some faculty wife and some people, they thought of this, that in IIT Kanpur we will have faculty houses, we will have officers houses, and lot of people will provide us domestic support. Someone will wash our clothes, someone will clean our utensils, someone will dust our houses. So this school, opportunity school, was formed in the late 60s for these people, for the families providing domestic support of IIT faculty and staff. And since then it is running, in a very good fashion, and we are able to provide good education and good exposure to children of these families. In our faculty houses, we have some outhouse also. So most of people live there and then they do work for the main faculty. And then some people come from the villages around the campus. So anyone who is involved in some fashion, some way or the other, to provide support to this IIT system, they are taken in this school. I was chairperson of this school before retirement for some 12-15 years. But before that, since it was established, I think late 60s, around 70s, so some 56, 57 years have already gone. People have developed it. We had a fee structure. But till my retirement, the fees was rupees 20 per month for the children. And after my retirement, it has been enhanced to 50 rupees or $1. Okay. So this is a school. It is in the campus of Kendriya Vidyalaya. If you get a chance, you are all in VH, I believe. If you get a chance, perhaps you can visit also. I can talk to the principal there. It's just opposite to BH, we have Kendriya Vidyalaya campus. And in that Kendriya Vidyalaya campus, only there is a block given to Opportunity School, in which there were some 5 rooms, and we run this school up to class 8. So 3 of the rooms, which were slightly bigger size, we put partitions, made 8 rooms there, so 8 classes run in that. And we have varieties of activities together with the regular teaching. We have staff of some 7 or 8 permanent teachers, which we have appointed. And on top of that, we are supported by IIT community, means several faculty wives, several students. They go there, they help, and they give different kinds of activities. And the so opportunities, who students are in many of the offices in IIT Kanpur. Our principal, founder principal, Srivastava, he was very fond of going from this office to that office, without any work. Because some opportunity school will be there, as a project assistant or somewhere on this table or that table. So many of this opportunity school students are in IIT Kanpur system. There's a opportunity school student who is sports coach in President House, Delhi. And every 5th September, he will call us. He will call the opportunity school and we'll talk to the principal or principal and acknowledge that yes, opportunity school has given him this training that he is doing so well. In BHU, some dean of course or something, he's from opportunity school, there are some scientists at ONGC. And then in the younger generation, the students who have graduated from here, they are in several NITs, IITs, like that. So we are able to provide quality education to these students. And this is the important thing, that IIT Kanpur has supported this school in a tremendous way. That is why we could do that. So infrastructural support, that building, that block in that Kendriya Vidyalaya campus that was given to us. So initially when the school was started, it was started in one of the type 2 quarters where we have 2 rooms and some space. We started there, then since the it worked very well. And worked very well because of the sincerity, because of the sensitivity, because of the commitment of the people who were involved. Because the financial support was almost zero that time. So people donated from their salaries and so on, from there it went on. And for a long time, just before I joined some 12 years ago, the teacher's salary was something like 1,000 rupees a month. But then the commitment was so high that the school was performing for the school. And so then from one quarter they gave another adjustment quarter, so 2 quarters made up of the school, and finally they gave this block in Kendriya Vidyalaya campus, and we have then another story to our campus and just come. So that infrastructural support they have given. Management committee is appointed by the IIT director. We have an official link. The IIT director appoints the committee and some faculty members are the chairperson. And 2 or 3 more faculty members will be in the management committee. And then the staff representative and teachers representative and all other. We have a management committee of some cabinet people, and they decide everything and they. That was a chairperson is a faculty, space provided with 8 classrooms, hall and playground, like that. Okay, now come to finance. Right now. That struggle period of those 40 years, 45 years, I have not really seen. But presently, during my junior when I was there, and then I talked to many people. So, there is an endowment fund created by various faculties of IIT Kanpur at that time. And this that time it was DPRC. Okay, that time it was DPRC, resource and planning. That office, that team, and people there, they were so nice to about the school because all the alumni will be in contact with that Dura office. And the Dura office, to anyone come to Dura office to make sure that the person visits the person in the school. And they come to, when they phone me that students at the university is in the campus, and we are arranging a visit to a particular school. So that is how we could generate that endowment fund. So we have this endowment fund that is created by various batches of IIT Kanpur alumni. Our total annual budget now is around 30 lakhs. When I had joined some 15 years ago, it was 4 lakhs. So now it has gone up by so much of amount. And IIT Kanpur directly supports rupees 5 lakhs. Right? So that's institute's contribution. So that 5 lakhs is there from the institute. And then individual contribution from IIT Kanpur employees, all faculty and all officers, they have given a standing instruction that this much amount of my salary per month should go to the quality school. That also adds to some 6-7-8 lakhs. And then the interest of the endowment fund, we are still, generally we are short of some 3-4 lakh rupees because normally what happens, we expand our activities beyond what we have. And that is how the institution grows. If I see this is the budget, what I can do with this budget, then I will not grow. If I decide that, okay, this is the activity I want to do, and then I have to create budget for that, I have to get funds for that, then it goes. So we are always short of some money. So right now also we have to report that school is generally a particular school is short, and then we work hard to get from here or from there, and then we do our activities. Alright, so the next phase is that this is up to class 8. And for quite some time, 7-8 years in fact, we wanted to take it up to class 10. Because 10th is some kind of a milestone. And 8th is somewhere in between. So 10th is a high school. So we wanted to take it to that level. And the biggest thing was space and building. Because going to 10 means now we cannot confine ourselves to very small classrooms where faculty students are staying. We have to have a lab, science lab, biology lab, and various activities and this and that. So we were looking for a big fund from which we can make a building. Space, we were very sure that IIT Kanpur will provide a space somewhere in the campus. So somehow, very fortunately, that before my retirement, 1 year before my retirement, I could find a donor. This is Chandralekha Singh from Pittsburgh University. She is from Bihar. And she knew about Shiksha Zupan. The link came through Shiksha Zupan. Shiksha Zupan newsletter every month we put up a 4-page newsletter which gives the activities of the previous month. And we send it to people who are in our contact. So Chandralekha Singh is also in that recipients list. So she used to get that Shiksha Zupan newsletter, and through that we were in contact. And then I proposed that, can you help? And she came up with a really generous helping hand, $1 million to IIT Kanpur for constructing building of a particular school to take it up to class. So IIT Kanpur has received that sum. IIT Kanpur has already given us the space, a big, large space, and the Bhumi Pujan has already been done, and the building is being constructed. And maybe next year, July or so, we will be able to shift there, and then our class 9, 10, 10th will come up from there. Once class 9, 10th comes up, this 30 lakh budget is going to become 45 lakhs, and we have to generate another 15 lakhs per year for that. So that's the kind of activities we are doing. this particular school. In the evening, we run another center which is called a particular college, and that idea came from our former dean, again, resource here, DRP dean, Dr. Sudhir Kumar Jain, who is at present director of IIT Kanpur. So he came up with, in fact, I was in his office, and suddenly he said that read this on the computer screen. He showed me a page, and it was written a positive college. The heading was a positive college. I said, what college? It is a positive school. He said, no, you need it. It is something new. So his idea was that in this school, in the evening, we give classes to the youth around this campus who are struggling for getting a small job. This is a big section, a very big section, who graduate and talk about that program, another program, on BSc. But they have absolutely no idea what this BA is, or what this BCom is, or what this BSc is. Nothing else to do after 12. To join something. And the colleges they join, they don't get any skill from there. So after graduation, they are just nowhere. They cannot talk, they cannot write, they cannot do simple calculations, and so on. They're all unemployed. And such people living around IIT Kanpur, Sudhir Kumar Jain was very upset about that. So he started this in the evening, we give courses. So that opportunity school started again, I think, some 10 years or so. So evening classes for youth around the campus, and this is all free. This is zero fees. So we asked for applications, and originally it was thought that people who have passed graduation, bachelor's degree, and looking for a job. But later on, it was thought that no. Why to wait till that time? Anyway, they are not going to colleges. Anyway, they are not getting anything from the colleges. So, from the second year of their bachelor program, perhaps. So that we have some good foundation. By the time they complete their degree, they also know something. And that can also help in their program also, in their bachelor program also. If we can teach them a little bit of English, perhaps their bachelor program will be better, no, because otherwise they don't know what is written in the book. Okay, so we invite applications, and whatever applications we get, some 200 to 50 applications we get, we interview them, and then select some 30-40, and then we give 3 months course. And it is again funded by our IIT Kanpur, the dean's office, Dora. The resource persons who give classes, some IITK students started with some IITK students, but later on it was found that it was difficult because students have their own timetables and examinations and this and that. So whoever is suitable, from IIT campus or from outside, whoever is suitable is brought and honorarium is given so that the classes run in a proper fashion. There is a coordinator. Coordinates all activities, so that is also funded by Dora office. And this is given in three topics. One is English, okay, and so one class is for English, another class is for arithmetic, so that they can do some calculations, that is basic calculations they can do, some arithmetic they can do. And the third is on computer literacy, and working with Office and Excel and PowerPoint like that. And then there's an advanced course we started recently, which teaches them accountancy, tally, and those kind of things. So those courses are going on. And I could not put it here, the performance output is free, guys. It's free. These students who were not able to speak, not able to make simple calculations, they were not exposed to computers, Kanpur, we have computer every few square feet, you will find one computer. But these people, these young boys and girls, they have seen computer only from the distance. Okay. So after doing this course, many of them are doing very well. Many of them have become project leaders in different companies, and they are guiding somebody, many people around them, and the confidence level and everything. So the performance is very good. Okay, she says one school or anopcharic shikshan ke liye informal learning center we have visited. So this was started by IIT Kanpur staff, students, faculties, and some local youth from the villages. So this is a non-registered government organization and run by IIT Kanpur community. The activities we have in Sopan Vidyalaya, where you have to go. The Sopan Vidyalaya it was started with the view that let us look at the children who are not going to any school. In spite of all efforts by the government, Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan and this and that, and there is a private school in every village, all those things are there, but still, many of the children do not go to school. Biggest reason is they know that these government schools are of no use. Guardians know that elderly is doing. When Shikshak Subhan was started by some of our students, fourth year teaching students in that, they started Shikshak Subhan. The first thing that they had in mind was to set up a center in some village outside, where those village children can come to the evening and spend time with IIT students. So they were looking for a place. So they came to know that there is a government school, Prathamik Vidyalaya, in Barasiro here. And so they thought that, okay, in the evening that school can be used for our center. So they tried to contact the authorities so that the permission be given for the evening classes in the school. And then, when they probed, they came to know that the school is never open. It's a school, but it's never open. In the day hours, it's all the time locked. So they had to locate the principal's house. So they went to the principal's house. And then they talked to him, and the principal said that, children are, or the families here are not interested in studying, no one comes to school. So what we do, so therefore we do not open the school. So they said, okay, you don't open the school, but in the evening let us open and do some activity there. And then the key could not be located with the key of that block, which is there on the floor. So for a long time it was locked. And the principal has forgotten where the key is. But IIT Kanpur students insisted that no, you have to give the key, otherwise you will report that your school is not open. So finally they found the key and they opened, and the center started. The first center started. And when the center started, hundreds of children from that Barasarai village started coming. And when the principal came to know that such a good evening center is running and hundreds of students of that locality are coming, so he felt very guilty. And then he came to our, Shiksha Subhan volunteers, IIT Kanpur students, and said that, why don't you ask these children to also come in the day hours and open the school? And that is how the school started functioning. After this evening cycle. Right? So that's the kind of situation the schools have there, but they know, these parents know that no point in sending the children there, no classes are there, no teachers come, nothing meaningful is done. And once you go to private schools, I'm not talking of DPS. They have 3-4 rooms perhaps, and they have started a school so that they can so that fees is also, now it has gone up, that fees is also some 400 rupees, 500 rupees per month. And when physicist one started, that fees was around 100 rupees, 150 rupees. Now 100 rupees, 150 rupees that time, some 50 years ago, and 500 rupees now is something is not easy for any of the families, and therefore the children are not going to school as a health. So this Shiksha Sopan or Namkarik Shiksha Kendra, that time we called it Sopan Vidyalaya, this was started with this view. We surveyed in that Parasurai village, we surveyed and every house we found where the children, child is not going to school, and some 80 such houses we could find in that particular village. And then we convinced them that, okay, we will not charge you any fees, you send out your children to this Sopan. And that is how it started, and that is how it is still going. Some 75, 80 students are still there, and IIT Kanpur students serve. Okay, then evening learning center is there. There are two evening learning centers. One you might have seen, because I was told you you went in afternoon. Right, so that Sopan Vidyalaya generally runs from morning 7:30 or 8 to up to 1 o'clock. And then evening, 4 o'clock, we have evening learning center where there is no registration. Registration, of course, there is no registration fees in the Sopan Vidyalaya also. But at least there we know that, okay, these are the students. But here it is all unaccounted. There is no documentation who comes and who goes. So this is open for all children going to any school. And they can come here, and our resource person will be there, and they will teach, they will solve their problems, they will expose them to various other things, and so on. So such evening centers are also running. So one is at that, in the same building that Sopan Vidyalaya, and another is in Nanka, which is 2 kilometers from this place. From this place, yeah. From this place it will be 2.2 kilometers or so. So it is in a village Nanka. So there we have a space which we call Sopan Ashram, and that in that ashram the children of that locality. About 100-120 children come there, and then some 7-8 IIT Kanpur students, and then from that locality there are some young volunteers, they act as resource persons, and that evening center goes on. Then we have this scholarship program, we have this science labs, and then we have construction celebrations. I have slides for this. So one detail I have already talked. And evening center, I have taught apart from actual English and maths and science, a lot of activities are done in evening centers. And since we have this privilege that we are close to IIT Kanpur, and in IIT Kanpur, various projects are going on, and various people are coming from outside, students come for internship and all that. So, this is our resource. So recently a girl came from Punjab or somewhere, and she was doing a project here on in aerospace department, very famous nowadays. And this girl, when she contacted us, she came to know about our activities here. She contacted us, she spent some time in Sopan Ashram, and she gave a extremely good workshop on this aeromodeling. So such a technical, specific, nice things we are able to get. One Julie, who is again an intern here at IIT Kanpur in some lab, she is giving music classes to our Sopan Ashram evening center. Classical music, she is teaching classical music. So that way we are very fortunate that we get those resources. But yes, since we have the system, since we have the platform, therefore, we are able to translate all those things there. This Dashera, this Dashera, our evening center children, they suggested that we will make rubber, like PG of rubber. Okay? So from a very modest thought that, okay, we will also make our own rubber, and we encourage all kinds of creativity. If anyone wants to do anything with the hands, we always encourage. Okay? So that's another problem with our education system. We spend too much of time on computer mouse and chalk and two-dimensional other things, tabs and this and that. One is three-dimensional, but we always work in two dimensions. So anything which is beyond that, if you do something in our three-dimensional space, that really connects you to life. So we always encourage something. So this proposal came, we will make rubber. So okay, fine. But then children were so involved in that, they came up with newer ideas, this way, that way, this way, this way, this way, that. Finally, it was a 15 feet high. And they learned so many things, how to put that 15 feet long thing in a stable fashion, right? So that it remains there before you put fire for at least 1 or 2 days, you have to put it there. So to make a stable structure 15 feet high, and the base cannot be 15 feet, of course, otherwise it is easy. The base has to be only 2-3 feet. So they learned a lot of equilibrium, signaturing, this and that, and they tried this way, tried that way. So they put some that basket type things in the legs, and then they dug and they put how much it should go inside and how much it should remain outside for the stability. Many things they learned. And there was a boy, a small boy, maybe some 8-9 years, and he also wanted to do a lot of things. He also had ideas, and somehow these senior ones, these 15 years, 16 years children, they were not giving due importance to this child. So he was very upset. He said, okay, I will not work with you. But to our surprise, he came with his own smaller version of the Okay. Alright. So the creativity is very much there in our this section. They are not exposed to good academic institutions. They are not going to a meaningful academic schools or like that. All these children I am talking of, they are learning in, they are going to schools which are that 400, 500 rupees and 2-room, 3-room and schools. Right? But they have a lot of potential. That potential is going waste. So if our institutions can look around and tap some of that potential, the total national output can be very, very high. Okay, so that's the summer camps. So during summers, we call some selected children and keep them here for 2 weeks, 3 weeks. And IIT Kanpur has always given us a space and other support. So from that summer camps, now this is the boy, it was this boy, this boy. He is now doing aerospace engineering, and then he was this small. That time itself, he used to tell that I will do aerospace. And he made it. He is doing aerospace engineering from Bharat Institute in Tamil Nadu. And he is doing very well. Projects and all those things. And he's been supported by his mother, still cooks food in different houses. Right? A very poor family. Father is has health problems. He is not earning any. And mother is earning. And mother is earning by going to this house, cooking food, going to that house, cooking food, going to that house. All his expenditure is met by successful one. The donation comes from some IIT Kanpur. So if you can sensitize people, a lot of things can be done. Similarly, this boy, this girl, this Poonam, she turned out to be a very good khokho player. Okay. With our support, she was admitted in a school, CPC school in a city, from where she did be 12. nationals in CBSE competition and this and that. And now she is taking charge of sports section of our unit.
Okay.
So, like our science cell is very, very active. Pehle dikhao tab sikhao. Our science cell is very, very active. We have developed lots of bacteria. We have developed more than 600 short experiments in science at different levels. Class 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, BSc. From 600, 700 short experiments means the experiments which can be performed in, say, 1 minute. So the idea is that a teacher when go to the class and teaches a topic, then if he can do this kind of a demonstration experiment of 1 minute to introduce the subject and then those kind of experiments. Of course, on that 1 minute experiment, you can discuss the science for another 10 minutes or 20 minutes or 30 minutes. That's another story, depending on the audience, depending on the situation. But the experiment itself is one. Quite simple thing. If you are teaching, let's say, bending of light when it goes from air to water, you know, just take a bottle, put some water there, put some smoke there, and put a laser light there, and you can show the bending. So it takes 1 minute or so. But now they understand what is the meaning of that angle of incidence, the angle of refraction, this and that. Otherwise, they have to just cram that the angle between the incident ray and normal is called, and so on. So those kind of experiments we have developed, and then we are moving out with those experiments to tell the teachers about that. So we do a lot of teachers training. So I have just come from Gujarat. The day before yesterday, I reached here. After a 10 days visit to Gandhinagar, where we gave teachers training to class 9-10 teachers from all districts of Gujarat. Gujarat Science Secondary Nagar. They had selected some government school teachers from every district of Gujarat, and 10 days we were there to give this science training. And most of these experiments, we go with some, depending on what audience is, some 20, 30, 40, 30 experiments. And based on that experiments, we give them training, how to teach, and so on and so forth. So our science is developing. Every day they develop one or two new experiments of this kind, and then they give workshops and all those things. We have done projects with Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan, all PGT. Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan gave Shiksha Dupan, and we also have another body called Indian Association of Project Teachers. So KVS gave a project to us to give exposure of this kind of teaching to all their PGTs nationwide. So we have completed about 3/4 of that, and 1/4 is still here. So those kinds of activities are going on. So these are some camps that we organized in our science center. Okay, we put up a center at Champawat. Champawat is a village in Uttarakhand. And when we put this science center there, there was a Professor H C Verma in IIT Kanpur. And he is from that area, Champawat area. So when he retired and settled there in Dhamdwani, he contacted Shiksha Dupan to put up a science resource center in the primary school in which Dr. Bish had himself studied. So we went from here. We went from here and to put up that science resource center. And very interestingly, the talks were going on that such a science center has to be put there and Shiksha Dupan can do it and this and that. And what we had asked him, one, space which he has arranged, then some funds, some material to purchase that materials and put up there, that he has arranged, and one coordinator who will run the center. Once I put the center, someone has to run. So one coordinator whom we will train during our stay there, that he could not. The last part he could not. Then they said, okay, you put the center, and the, when we will find some person, we will train them, or we will call you again, or something we will do, but at least put that girl. Don't postpone. So we went with our bags and this and that, 4 hours from each other. And then the but that particular village was not on the route of that bus or any vehicle. We had to drop some 3 kilometers away from the village, and that 3 kilometers we had to do trek. Okay. So he had asked one gentleman to guide us from that spot where the bus will leave me to that particular village. So someone will guide us, and then we will go together. And so during that 3 kilometer walk, I talked to that guide. What are you doing, and this and that. Naturally, if you are going 3 kilometers, you have to walk, you will talk. And then I came to know that this person is doing BCom. That's right. And then during that walk of 3 kilometers, I told them the whole idea of this science resource center. And then I invited him to look at, we are going to put up all these things, and since you are from that village, so in the evenings, etc., when the classes are off, you can come to us and help us in putting. And finally, he became the coordinator of the Science Education Center, and he ran that center very well till he was there for 3 years. For 3 years. And in these 3 years, of course, many more were trained, and this is still going on. The center is still going on. Dr. Bush writes to us many times. So those kind of things can be done. And so we are, through this center, we are giving a meaningful exposure, education to people for whom we do not have even a bus facility. Right? So that's the kind of action we are talking about. Then we have regular functions. What I have not talked is scholarship. Item called scholarship, and we had a extremely competent professor of physics here in IIT Kanpur, Dr. B. H. Kulkarni, whom we lost early because of cancer. He expired in his 50s only. So, and he was one of our philosophical guide. He had very clear views of what to be done for society. And during talks on the social aspects, we learned a lot from him, and that guided us. So when he expired, we instituted this scholarship in his name, Dr. B. N. Kulkarni Medical Scholarship. And this is perhaps 7th year of that scholarship. So in this we conduct a test in this locality, 5 kilometers from IIT Kanpur campus, on all sides, that annular ring of total 5 kilometers. So that in that we have something like 80 schools. Right? If I go 5 kilometers from IIT Kanpur, this side, that side, that side, that side, at least 80 schools are there. 80 schools are in our contact. We could find them. We could go there. There may be more. We might have missed. So these 80 schools, and the average population in these schools is, let's say, around 100. Okay, around 100, 150. Some schools are there with 50 children, 60 children, some are there with 300 children or so. So maybe 150 could be the average. So into 80. Right? So how much is it? 150 into 80. So those many students are here. Those many students are here. 10,000 students are here. And the fees varies from, again, 300 rupees to 500 rupees. And the infrastructure. For some of the better ones, we have some infrastructure, good infrastructure. 3,000 rupees per month. That is the average teacher salary. Most I know, but the children are there. The children are the population is there. So many children are studying there.
So who are these teachers? I mean, how they can save 3,000?
That's what I told. After doing for many of these people, they do not have anything. They cannot talk, they cannot understand, they cannot do arithmetic, they cannot be employed by a shopkeeper. So, a school is one organization who can still employ these kind of people. If you have a shop and you want to employ a helper, that helper must understand what the customer is telling. He should be able to distinguish between this and that. But a school is an organization where you really don't need anything. You just need two persons, two hands, so that you ask children to sit down and do some, I don't know. So those kind of people are also there. And those kind of schools are also.
But the quality of education given by these kind of
exactly. That is why we are needed. See, recently we did an appointment in a opportunity school, and we got not many applications, and then we interviewed some of them after a screening, written screening. And during the interview, we asked these candidates, and they were good. Reasonably good candidates, in the sense that after screening, from 200 to 300 applications, and after screening we interviewed some 20 of them. So they were reasonably good out of that lot. So we asked, okay, why do you want to leave your own school and come here? And the simple reply was, there we are getting 2,000 rupees a month, or 3,000 a month, and here you are getting 9,000 a month. So that was simple. So that's the kind of situation, sir. That's the kind of situation. So these 8,000-10,000 students are going in these kinds of schools. So what will happen to these? And that is why we are needed. That is why our intervention is needed. So we run our scholarship program for these children.
These schools are
so if there are say 200 students and the fees is let us say how much? 500. Let us say 500. 500 fees and 200 students. That's their income. In which they have to run 8 classes. Or 10 classes. Or 6 classes. And they have to appoint one teacher for every class. So those many teachers have to be appointed. And then they have opened the school for business. So they need money for themselves also. So that's the reality, that's the ground reality. You move out of your campus and then you will know that, okay, this is the actual reality. Very recent, I did this interview was just a month ago, and people still told me that the salary I'm getting there is 2,000 rupees or 2,500 rupees. You are getting 9,000, so that's what I am.
There are many
for a good physics teacher for their class 11. And they are saying that for 3 years we are searching for the teachers, we are not getting to the teachers, and therefore we are cheating our students. Give me a physics teacher, we are ready to pay 25,000 to 30,000 rupees. But the teacher should be of our. That is that. And we are not getting. They are not getting. Same story. From Bihar I got a call. From Hajipur. From Hajipur I got a call in one evening. I didn't know the person. And the lady says that I am principal of Fentonsense College. And somehow we are not getting a teacher of physics, and therefore in class 9-10 our chemistry and math teacher are giving physics classes and they are not able to do that. So can you give me some physics teacher? I asked how much you will be paying. She said if someone is there of reasonable quality, something like 30,000 is okay with us. And then at that time there was a person who was working with me in Shiksha Dupan, and he was looking for a job. And since he had worked with me in our activities for 3-4 years, he had some good understanding of teaching and physics and demonstrations and experiments and this and that. So I told the lady, okay, I'll send a person and you try this person for a week or so, and then you may talk to him, and if you can. So I said this boy, Anurag Pandey, not really very good to my standards, his understanding and all this is not very good, but still. And when he went there, he gave that one week of classes, the entire management committee was after that. You don't have to go to Kanpur, you have to stay here. And he's working there, 30,000 rupees per month. On one side, there are people with good degrees, they are not getting a job of 10,000 rupees. On the other side, the employer are asking, where are the people, person? Where is the person who I can employ? The people who are serious. The people who are serious about their students, about the reputation of their school, they want to teach us. And so, they are not getting good teachers. So, a lot of mismatch.
In many cases, like you know, here you gave example, the school principal need not to open it for number of years. There also they need not to go to school for 6 months or a year together.
Right.
So, you know, this is a lot of disparity and very painful.
Correct. So salary is not related to the commitment. Salary and commitments are two different things. But yes, if people are working at 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 rupees in 2018, then we can definitely know about the capabilities. Okay? There's another side of that story also. The government school teachers also. For last 3 years, I'm working more intensely with government school teachers. The Gujarat training camp was also with government school teachers. And UP also with government school teachers, we are working more closely for the last 3 years or so. What I have found is, the quality of those teachers is very good. The quality of those government school teachers is very good, contrary to the general perception that they have tried and they have entered the system. No, on the average, the quality of government school teachers is very good. They are demotivated. When we give training under Raspi Avishkar of Vyan IIT Kanpur, also we gave some training to these government school teachers of Kanpur and around. So when we gave training some few sessions, they were bubbling with enthusiasm. And then there were so many WhatsApp videos that when they went back to their schools, they did wonderful jobs. Wonderful jobs. One of the teachers, Seema, of the Shivrajpur area around here, some 60 kilometers or so from here. She conducted a science exhibition in her school. And for that, she did not take any money from principal or school administration or DIOS or BSA. that you are good, you can do this and you can do that. So it's a very complex and different kind of situation. One has to go into the field to understand. So that scholarship we conduct, and we give some 15 scholarships to these children. We select some 15 students per year and we give a scholarship. The scholarship amount is very small. 2,500 rupees per month for class 6 and 8. 3,500 for 9-10. And then 4,500 per year for 11th. But this had made an impact. These schools, the average fees is around 400. So 12 months, something 4,000-5,000, they have to pay the fees. That they pay, the parents pay. Because if they don't pay, the school will just strike the name off. That they pay. But it's very painful for them to pay that much. And therefore, where the students suffer is, the students will not get books, stationery, drawing blocks, pencils, those things the students will not get. Only that much. This is small scholarship, 3,000 rupees. And we make sure, we don't give the scholarship in one second go. We give a small amount, half amount. And we make sure that the books are purchased, the stationery is purchased, then we will get the rest. So now the student is good, has gone through that experiment, that is scholarship test. And of course, after the test, we also go individually, home to home, family to family, and look at the economic conditions and then decide. Every student will be visited by our volunteers, and we will note everything, what kind of roof is there, what kind of floor is there, whether it is motorcycle, or it is only a cycle, or what. Everything we will note, and then our committee will decide. And this family, when gets this 3,000 rupees or 2,000 rupees, the books and the stationery are there in the room with the child from the very first day, it makes a difference. So those kind of activities are also there.
Sir, recently you had been to Gujarat. Have you visited any Gandhian school in villages?
No.
Because same ideology is there. And Gujarat is the same university, founded by Mahatma. Same university is running all many schools across the state. So next time when you go, please have an opportunity to visit such school. And you can have some more ideas from
there. Sure. In fact, I did interact with the vice chancellor of the Gujarat Okay. We spent some time together. But since this was a packed program of 10 days in IITE, Indian Institute of Teacher Education. So from morning to evening, the participants also stayed there and the classes were there. So I could not move much here. Okay, so that is about Shikshan Zupan. There were some personal achievements which I skipped. This Hanuman, this boy came to our contact, Shikshan Zupan. His family runs on selling things in IIT Kanpur campus. His brother is the head of the family. And he goes house to house, and sells eggs. Right. And after this Hanuman completed 10th, the elder brother wanted him to join the business so that he can go support families and earn more money. But somehow, in Shiksha Rupan, since we had seen his potential, we counseled his brother to allow him to continue for higher studies. He did 12, then he did various doctoral courses and then various other here and there courses. And now he is a reasonably good in a good position. He was in EduTech and he was a resource person for new invents and this and that, earning some 50,000 rupees a month now, so, like that. This person, Deepu, he also came to our Shiksha Rupan thing. His father is a carpenter and he also did quite well, and now he is a contractor. He takes contracts of making buildings and other things. In IIT Kanpur also, he has taken projects. This furnishing of our newest lecture complex, L17, and on that side, that is done by this one. putting up his thela. There was a person putting a dosa thela. Dosa, idli dosa. Near hospital, hospital 3 and after that in SPR. So she is daughter of that vendor. And always, always full with loans. Because that dosa thela could not give a great amount of money. So this girl was supported by Shiksha Dubai. And now she is in Wipro. She's a project officer at Wipro. And that person has stopped putting together. Okay. All those things. So I did support, I talked to that.
What topics are there in this year, second year, in physics?
he did not. Then I asked, during class, did college people help you in writing in the exam, during the examination, this and that? He said, no, yeah, some help is provided, but not much. We have to prepare. How do you prepare? You don't know whether it is optics or mechanics which is there in the paper. How do you prepare? Then I knew the story that we, before the exam, 1 month before the examination or 2 months before the examination, publishers come out with a booklet which is called Easy Notes for all subjects and all examinations. So those, once the easy notes are in the market, these students will go and purchase them. And these are thin booklets for one paper, maybe 100 pages maximum. Kunji, right, 100 pages maximum. And they will not know whether it is thermodynamics or whether it is statistical mechanics or whether it is relativity or whether it is condensed matter. They only know that on the top page, cover page, it is written BSc second year third paper. And that is enough. I know that my third paper is on the 22nd of March. So when I go on 22nd of March, I should have a grant on this particular book. And when next day when I am going for the third paper or fourth paper, then this particular book. So that the cram and whatever they recollect, they write and some of the pass. That's the kind of thing. But if 5-6 lakh students are there.
Sir, unka samman hona chahiye. वो लोग इतने सिद्ध हैं कि रटने बाद भी कुछ भी ब्रेन पे रखे हैं, वो भी आसान नहीं है. लिख के आने के बाद भी ब्रेन को छुआ रहे हैं, सिद्धि प्राप्त कर रहे हैं.
So, but if there are 6 lakh of this kind of young persons of the age 20 years, 18-20 years, should we leave them out? Can we afford to leave that huge mass of our youth, 18-20 years old? With the technology we can reach out. And these people all write in Hindi. I talk to many students, these all people, they write in Hindi. Final examination. So what Shiksha Sopan has undertaken this year is, we will record video lectures in Hindi for all BSc syllabus, physics, chemistry, biology. And I started it with my course. I recorded 25 video lectures on special theory of relativity, Sapir, Shikpak and Music Dharmadhan. And those 25 lectures course is already, that the registrations are going on. Till date, 10,800 registrations are made. My dream is to make it 10 times, at least 10 times more. So the challenge is how to reach these students. I asked the people in university how to reach them. So some suggestions have come, we are working on that to reach them. But the whole thing is, even if I go and put a poster in their college, it will not help because the students are not coming to college anymore. So that's a bigger challenge. So we need people who can record their lectures in Hindi and in other languages. Similar could be story in other places also. So these higher institutions, institutions of higher learning, if you can sensitize some people to do these kind of activities, run MOOCs, run courses for this section, for this underprivileged section, that can